The guava will not fall on the tree. Don't wait for it to fall. Sumpit na yan. There must be an effort. God already made the promise that we will receive new things this year. Let's launch out into the deep. Launch out into the deep. And let us experience for a kickoff 21 days of prayer and fasting.
Amen.
I will start tomorrow. And I will not use that tomorrow. I will not say, I will start tomorrow. I will really start tomorrow. Kasi pagdating ng tomorrow, I will start tomorrow. Yes, Lord, I will start tomorrow. Tomorrow never comes. But tomorrow, I will really start. From 7 to 3. Then call it over. Huwag ka naman kumain ng baboy kagad kapag alas 3 na. Just break it slowly. And I believe it will even discipline me, myself, you know. Because I had seen my doctor last week. It's very time. Because my doctor says, change my diet. I almost want to change my doctor. My doctor. Whoever that doctor will be, he will say, they will tell me the same, change your diet. This is a timely exercise for me.
Sure, doctor.
Especially after being into the Philippines in the past 3 weeks palang, you know. But it's good. So this is the first part. Now I don't know the technicalities how they're doing it. Of course, Sister Marisa is our in charge of our prayer and fasting. Pastor Henry will be the one implementing this. I don't know how they will do it, but let us start tomorrow. Prayer and fasting. Okay? Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Now couple it with prayer, not only fasting. Okay? A voluntarily going without food in order to focus on prayer. Now you can still go to work, you can still do the normal things that you're doing, but be conscious of the presence of God. Be conscious of the presence of God in your life. So we're doing this not only on a physical level, not only on a mental level, but spiritual level as well. And I believe it will prepare us all, hallelujah, to experience the new things that God has prepared for you and for me this 2016. Amen?
Amen.
Let's give God a big round of
applause. Hallelujah.
Now, to kick off our 21-day prayer and fasting, let us experience today, as we have already been doing, every year is the annual anointing of oil. Now, oil is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. We are in the dispensation of the Holy Spirit. Church age, we are in the dispensation of the Holy Spirit. After we accepted the Lord in our hearts as our Lord and Savior, the Bible says our bodies become the temple of the Holy Spirit. Right? You know? When Jesus died on the cross, the Bible says the veil of the temple was rent. It was sliced into two. It signifies that the presence of God doesn't dwell in buildings, but he dwells now in your body and in my body. Now, aside from him being in our body and our bodies being the temple of the Holy Ghost, there is another experience that we should experience, and that is the overflowing infilling of the Holy Spirit in our lives. It's one thing for the glass to be full of water. It's another thing for that glass to be overflowing with water. Amen.
Amen? Amen?
Let us not be contented by just being full of water. Let us experience the overflowing power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. And that is another experience. In Luke 24, 49, before Jesus ascended into heaven, he told his disciples in Luke 24, 49, "Behold, I send the promise of my Father." Look at the promise, it's capital P. It speaks about the Holy Spirit. Okay? "Behold, I send you the promise of my Father upon you, but wait in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power." Everybody say power.
Power.
"Until you be endued with power." From where? From on high. So, before he ascended into heaven, he told the 500 disciples in front of him. 500 disciples said, "Okay, wait for me in Jerusalem. You will receive the promise of the Father." Now, this promise was also said in John chapter 14 and 16, wherein he said, I will go, but the Father will send the Comforter, and he shall be with you. The Paraclete, the Holy Spirit. Okay? So, this promise actually happened in Acts chapter 2. 500 heard. Listen to me carefully. 500 disciples heard this. But only 120 showed up in Jerusalem. Yeah. 500 were told. Only 120 appeared in the upper room at the day of Pentecost. So Acts chapter 2 verse 1. "When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one accord in one place." You see, this is the verse that says that the only biblical car is the Honda Accord.
Genesis.
Balik ko nga sa word. Di ba ako tapos hope? So natatawa si Isa kasi she just bought a Honda Accord. So the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all in one accord in one place. Verse 2. "And suddenly..." Everybody say suddenly.
Suddenly.
"And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were." So there's no magical way on how to be filled with the Holy Spirit. They say, "Oh, you should stand up. Oh, you cannot receive it until you kneel down." Hey, we're sitting down. So just be surprised. Maybe while you're sitting down, you'll be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So it's not a matter of the posture, it's a matter of the heart. Hello? Always the heart. God looks at the heart. So it filled the house. Wow, rushing mighty wind. You know, the first time I experienced being filled with the Holy Spirit, few months after I was born again in 1982, we were in a small room. There were about 12 of us. We were holding each other's hands and we were praying and worshiping, and suddenly we heard this, literally. I was 18 years old. It's wind above our head. And then we were just hit by the Holy Spirit, spoke in other tongues, and my life was never the same again. Because this promise, as written in Acts chapter 2, I think 39, this promise is not only for the disciples, but to those who are afar off, as many as the Lord will call. Everybody say call.
Call.
Call. Now, ecclesia, where is a Greek word where we get the word church. It came from the Greek word ecclesia. It means the called out ones. So church is not a building. Church are people, you and me, who have surrendered their lives to God. As many as the Lord will call. If you're part of the church, you are entitled to receive the power from on high.
Amen.
So a rushing mighty wind, it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Verse 3. "Then there appeared to them cloven tongues, divided tongues as a fire, and it sat upon each of them, like a flame on top of their head." Verse 4. "And they were all filled." Everybody say filled.
Filled.
So, you know, when you read the Bible, let us be observant with all the words. Because if one can be filled, it means one can be empty, one can be half filled. So when it says filled or overflowing, there can be a quantity of presence of the Holy Spirit, power of the Holy Spirit. They were filled with the Holy Ghost. and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Verse 5. And there were dwellings in Jerusalem, Jews, devout men. If you continue on, people were amazed. They thought they were drunk, and it was only 3 p.m. in the morning, 3 p.m. in the afternoon. But they did not understand that these people are being filled by the power from on high. Now, I pray, we have many experiences like this in the church. I pray that this morning we will experience the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As I anoint you with oil in the name of the Lord, receive the anointing, receive the faith level for us to really receive the new things for this 2016. Amen. Because again, it will not come automatically. Every promise of God comes with a condition. You will be saved when? If you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Right? God will open up the windows of heaven if you bring all the tithes into the storehouse. You will receive. Pressed down, shaken together, running over. What's the condition? If we will give. Believe and you will receive. How will you receive? If you believe. In the same way, God has promised us that we will experience new things for this year, but we have to launch into the deep. We have to receive the anointing. We have to be empowered by the Holy Spirit to believe that we will truly receive new things for this year. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. How can we do it? Prepare your hearts. Prepare our hearts. Be hungry. The Bible says, as the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs after you. Want it. Desire it. Long for it. Psalm 84, verse 10, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. How can God fill it if you don't open up your mouth? So this year, this is part of preparing the hopers, preparing us to receive new things. As we anoint you with oil in the name of the Lord, by faith. And there's nothing magical about the oil again. Don't ask me if you can buy that oil. I will tell you to go to 99 cents, it's cheaper. And we don't sell it. It's just a symbol. When we receive the anointing of oil, receive the anointing. You see, it's spiritual. Hello? Huh? I cannot explain. Spiritual man. You know, we have discussions because I see Alma, can you lift up your hand? Say, hello, Alma.
Hello.
Alma is one of my members when we were in Singapore 12, 15 years ago together with Patrick and everyone, and Lorna. I was visiting a boarding care in San Gabriel Valley. And then, as I enter the facility, I say, familiar, siya na. And you know, every time we have meetings with the company that I work with, it's palliative and hospice. And they would ask, and the nurses and the social workers would ask, how is spiritual important in taking care of the patient? How is spirituality important in the restoration or cure in a patient's well-being. You know, I would often tell them, I can't explain it. Because if I can explain it, then it should be emotional. Then it's emotion. How can you explain spiritual? Right? It is not what I can do. It's not what man can do. Spiritual is something that only God can do. Hello? Right? Yeah? So, Sabi, do you have the perfect words to say? Do you lay your hands to them? Is your hand shaking when you... And we have seen people, di ba? Yung mga naglele, pinuto lang. Right? Have you seen it in YouTube?
Yeah.
You know? Oh, he was lame, man. How are you doing? I hit my head and it hurts. Now listen to me. The last thing that we will do here in Hope for the World is to help God move. To help God move. God doesn't need any help if He wants to move.
Amen.
We don't have to push you. We don't have to shout at you. We don't have to give nothing that we can do. That's why it's spiritual. Hello? Kung hindi circus lang tayo. Let's just go to circus land. You know? That's why it's spiritual, because it is beyond our mental capacity to understand, beyond our physical to understand. That's why it's spiritual. Only God can do it. Right? Yeah? Gusto talaga, na-feel ko, bakit nanginginig yung kamay ko? Naku, pastor, talaga ako'y na-feel. Bakit? Ako'y bumagsak. Nung bumagsak, kapag na yung ano nangyari, ala, bumagsak ka lang. Let's be practical, right?
Yeah.
Huh? Now, yes! Yes, I believe that when people lay their hands and people will be slain, I believe that. But don't... Huwag nating... Alam niyo na yun. God help God. Sometimes you will not feel anything and you don't really have to feel anything to be filled by the Spirit of God. Yung mga physical manifestations of people crying, people falling down, those are all physical manifestation of what happened in the inside of them. Right? Well, nothing may have happened to you when I lay hands on you and anoint you with oil. But if something happened to you on the inside, then it does the work. And that's it. Hello? Kasi minsan there are emotional people. Now they really need to feel. You don't really have to feel. If you can feel it, it's not by faith. Everything is by faith. Faith is operated by not what you feel. Faith is operated by what you believe. Hello? Now, kung na-sling ka, now some people would feel heat coming from their head down to their toes, then praise God. Then I expect some changes in you afterwards, right? Huh? Hello? Kung nanginig ka nga, bumagsak ka nga, payak-iyak ka nga, pagkatapos sakit ka pa rin ang ulo ng pastor afterward, walang nangyari. Hello? Hello? Let's not fake ourselves. Amen?
Amen.
Let's not play church.
Amen.
Let's be spiritual. That's why there are people sick and tired of coming to church, because it's just ceremony, it's just being religious. Let's not be religious here. Let's just always do the main thing, and the main thing is to feel the presence of God in your heart and by faith.
Amen.
Believe. Not through physical manifestation. Now, I'm not saying I'm anti-physical manifestation. Ano lang yun? Kumbaga,
bonus
na lang yun. Hello? Right? Amen?
Amen.
It's just an added attraction. If you feel something, and I'm not against it, you know. I often cry when I experience the presence of God. I often kneel down when I experience the presence of God. Reaction, yun lang yung reaction ko sa naramdaman ko dito. Pero kung nakafocus ka lang sa physical at sa emotion, wala naman nangyari sa loob mo. It's just being religious. They were just playing church here. Which it's tiring to play church. Right?
Yep.
Punong-punong na lang ng plastic and ng mga player. Let's just change our church name to Tupperware Hope for the World. Tupperware for the World. That will be the last thing that will happen in this church. Amen?
Yeah.
We are always proof for ourselves. Politics here. We want to receive the genuine move of God. We want to receive the genuine touch of God. Amen. Now, if you're overwhelmed by your emotion, let it be. Let it be. It's your time with God. If you want to kneel down, lie down, cry, howl, jump, laugh, smile, it's up to you. It's between you and your God anyway. Amen?
Amen.
And that's what we want to receive. The genuine touch from heaven above. Nothing less than that. That makes our church the best church. That makes our church a genuine church. Right?
Amen.
It's very tiring to play church. Let's not kid ourselves. Let's just be true to ourselves. Let us stop being hypocrites and let's stop being plastic. Para bang yung babae, sabihin nyo, alam mo ikaw, pag nag-swimming tayo, lulutang ka. Sabi niya, bakit? Dahil mataba ako? Hindi, dahil plastic ka. Lahat ng mga hoppers lulubog. Kasi we're launching into the hindi ko na alam ang sinasabi. Basta we want to receive the genuine touch of God. Amen? After being in the ministry for 30 years, I have seen everything in church. I was in our sister church in El Paso, Texas last Sunday. My heart was burning. Suddenly there was fear in my heart. I know it's not from God, but so let's be true to ourselves. Stop playing politics and stop playing church. So let us receive the anointing this morning. Amen?
Amen?
If you believe that, if you believe that God is preparing you to receive new things from God, as I anoint you with oil in the name of the Lord, receive it in the name of Jesus. Can we just all stand? Worshiping, can you come and sing our last song, the last song of this set?